Well, testimony is now underway in the murder trial of the former UVA lacrosse player accused of killing his ex-girlfriend. And it's already unfolding into an emotional and graphic series of witness accounts. 11 News reporter Lowell Melser is live from the latest with the event in Charlottesville, Virginia. Lowell?
Yeah, Rod, and that testimony continues at this hour. But after finally seating a jury after two very long days, opening statements and the Commonwealth's first witnesses were called to the stand, including Yeardley Love's mother. However, the most unexpected statements so far actually came from the defense as they presented their opening statements, saying that George Huguely is not capable of maintaining a lie, saying, quote, he's not complicated, he's not complex, he's a lacrosse player. As evidence is officially presented in the George Huguely murder trial, opening statements by both sides take the better of 2 hours Wednesday morning. Virginia Commonwealth Attorney Warner Chapman's statements mostly surround the night Love was found dead, explaining how the evidence would show George Huguely kicked in the door to Love's bedroom, leaving behind DNA, and he highlighted violent emails sent from Huguely days before the killing, including one with a quote, I should have killed you, unquote. Chapman went on to say that forensic evidence would show Love died from blunt force trauma and that it took her 2 hours to finally die after sustaining her violent injuries to the head. Huguely's attorney, Francis Lawrence, told the court Huguely and Love's relationship was an on-again, off-again one where they cheated on each other throughout and that tempers flared both ways. Lawrence said medical experts would prove that Love died from positional asphyxia by laying weird in her bed after mixing alcohol with prescription drugs, and that when Huguely was told by police of Love's death, he said, quote, nothing I did last night could have killed her, unquote, referring to the fact that he was in her apartment the night she died. As far as witnesses, Sharon Love, Yeardley Love's mother, was first called to the stand. While she broke down several times during opening statements and had to be consoled, she kept her composure as she told the court about how police came to her to tell her that her daughter had died. Her testimony was short and to the point, as was that from her sister Lexi and cousin Mary Ryan, basically talking about going up to UVA to gather Love's possessions after her death. As far as getting to the meat of the case, the fourth witness, Caitlin Duff, Love's former suite mate and teammate, testified about the night before Love's death, the email exchanges between Love and Huguely, and how she was told with the rest of the lacrosse team about her death. Now, Judge Edward Hogshire made it very clear today before today's court session started that he would have no problem going past 6 o'clock, and it appears that's what's going to happen this evening. But coming up at 6 o'clock, we'll have more testimony, which, by the way, is continuing at this hour, from Love's downstairs neighbor on what she heard and saw the night Love was found dead, as well as from Love's best friend and roommate, who was the last to see her alive and the first to find her dead. We're live in Charlottesville, Virginia tonight. I'm Lowell Melser, WBAL-TV 11 News.